Okay, I have here the two electric motors out of a 2004 through 2009 Toyota Prius that make up the transaxle, and I've just got a demonstration of magnetic field strength for these electric motors. The two motors are motor generator number one right here, which starts the engine and acts as an alternator. And then we have motor generator number two over here, which propels the vehicle. And then we have a planetary gear set that connects the two together, along with a clutch looking disc that connects the engine to the planet carrier of that electric motor pack here. So these two electric motors are inside the transaxle. These are permanent magnet electric motors and have some very strong magnets inside of them. And then the stator coils that these motors go inside of produce an electromagnetic field that pulls the motor around, or the motors around, to propel the vehicle. Well, I have another Toyota hybrid transaxle apart right here with the same motor generator number two right here, motor generator number one over here, a clutch damping disc up front that hooks to the engine, and then two planetary gear sets, a power split device planetary gear set, which is the same as what we have over here in the Prius transaxle, but then we also have a motor speed reduction gear set down inside here that allows this motor to have additional torque, but it also lets it spin at much higher speeds, up to 14,000 RPM. But the thing I wanted to show you is both of these transaxle motor packs are made of have very strong magnets inside of them. So watch the electric motors on this Prius transaxle as I bring the electric motors from the Highlander transaxle in proximity. You can see just by moving it over, the magnetic field caused the Prius electric motor to move just a little bit, and that's because that's evidence of the force of attraction and repulsion from the permanent magnets that are in this MG2 attracting or repelling the permanent magnets in that MG2. But more interesting here, to show the strength of the magnetic field, I've got a pretty good gap in between there, probably 3 inches or so. But watch what happens as I rotate the Toyota Highlander hybrid P310 transaxle MG2. Watch what happens to the Prius MG2. So I'm not touching the Prius motor at all, but yet the force of the magnetic field from the Highlander MG2 causes the Prius MG2 to spin. And if I go the opposite direction, then it also spins the opposite direction. So obviously this isn't some sort of technical diagnostic, but it's evidence of a very strong magnetic field that allows us to use what are called synchronous AC motors. Some people call them brushless DC motors, but these are very powerful electric motors used in hybrid and electric vehicles also.